Hi, my name is Ledisi. I'm a 12-time Grammy-nominated recording artist, and this is my showbiz story. I remember coming to New York just for a visit. I was visiting a friend who had moved from San Francisco to New York. His name, Richard E. Waits, and he's a wonderful actor and performer. And he let me sleep with him at his house. He had a bunch of roommates, but I slept on the floor next to his bed because, you know, that's the New York way. You squeeze in where you could fit in. Anyway, he introduced me to Miss Linda Twine. Now, I didn't know who Miss Linda Twine was or anything about her. I just knew she was a big deal. And she said, "Hey, Ledisi, I heard a lot about you. Sing for me." And I said, "Sure, Miss Twine, I'll sing for you." So I sang for her. And I guess it impressed her so much that she said, "I want you to come back tomorrow. I want you to meet me somewhere and be on time. I want you to do something for me." And I was like, okay, Miss Linda Twine wants me to do something. And then I looked her up and found out she had worked with me in The Horn and The Wiz and all these big, huge musicals and been a part of Black history. You know, this is historic, a legend that I just met and knew nothing about her and educated myself. The next day I showed up and in front of me was a composer, musical composer named Jeannie Tesori, and I knew nothing about her. You know, all I know is recording artist, soul music and gospel and jazz and opera, and I knew nothing about New York City and it's this whole world of Broadway, and here I am being in this huge theater with Miss Twine and singing to Jeannie Tesori. So I sing to her, and this is the production of Caroline or Change, and ended up leaving that building, and Miss Twine's talking to me about, "So how quickly can you move to New York?" And I'm thinking, what is she talking about? I came here for a visit. And she said, "Well, if you want it, you have a job." And I was like, oh my God. And so I moved to New York, I think a month later, and slept on my friend's floor and decided, yeah, I'm gonna quit recording, being a recording artist, and just focus on doing musicals. And there I was in New York City, hiding out, trying to change my career. And I ended up being understudy on Carolina Change, the radio and a washing machine. And it was an amazing experience to learn how to be a theater person in that way on Broadway. And then she introduced me to more people that were working on this little musical called The Color Purple. What? They were building it and working on the characters, and it's the making of it. And I auditioned for that, and thanks to Miss Linda Twine, and ended up being a part of the making of The Color Purple. I mean, not only I get one job, I got two. So yeah, and the rest is history. I eventually left Broadway because I had to decide between, do I do my record deal or do I do The Color Purple? And I ended up taking my record deal, and here I am now, a 12-time Grammy nominated recording artist. So I'm grateful for my experience on Broadway, and I'm grateful for Miss Linda Twine opening a whole new world for me. And yeah, that is my showbiz story. Now I'm gonna make mistakes from time to time.